that were submitted on Gates' behalf, and she did take them seriously. We at least know that she quoted for them quite literally when she handed down Rick Gates' federal sentence today. But the judge in the Gates case also did take issue with one assertion that had been made about Rick Gates in one letter that was sent to the forensic behalf, and that one assertion was something that the judge plainly just couldn't abide. And so she called it out in open court in a way that I think maybe gives us our best new idea for a t-shirt that could potentially explain the news this week. Here's what the judge said today in court. Quote, one of the letter writers said that Gates got caught up in D.C. political drama. But I reject that. It is perfectly possible to conduct yourself with ethics, integrity, and no hint of scandal, even in politics, even in Washington, D.C., even in Ukraine. Politics don't corrupt people. People corrupt politics. Just in case we need a better bumper here. Politics don't corrupt people. People corrupt politics. Judge Amy Berman Jackson in federal court in Washington today, while she was in the process of sentencing Rick Gates, the deputy chair of the Trump presidential campaign and the number two official on the Congress. Interesting, though, this particular judge hasn't just overseen the Rick Gates case. She has overseen more criminal prosecutions stemming from the Mueller investigation than any other judge in the country. She's had a whole bunch of them. And at this sentencing for Rick Gates today, she rips Rick Gates for the severity of his crimes. She praises Rick Gates for accepting responsibility for his crimes and pleading guilty and becoming a wholehearted cooperator with prosecutors. Indeed, he has agreed to keep cooperating with prosecutors in multiple ongoing matters, even after his sentencing today.